And I know that there's no limit. We pursuing all our dreams and we gon' make it.
And tell the world that the best is yet to come. Can you hear me?
Dreams. You'd think they were nightmares the way they scream. I make them believe. Woo. Someday, someday, I'm gonna be the next.
Welcome to Talk to the Hand. My name is TJ Story, your host. I just want to say that I love French fries. And I just want to give a shout out to all the French fry lovers. Today is a beautiful day. And I'm in a really great mood today. Anyway, today we're going to be celebrating Deaf History Month. Moments in history. So today I have found six really interesting people that we're going to talk about who have really changed the world. They have used their skills in different areas, in education, in the government, medical, television, entertainment, and the last thing is sports.
Come on.
So come on. Hello, and welcome back to A Moment in History. Today we're going to honor Deaf History Month. We're going to talk about our deaf culture today. So there's six inspiring people that have really changed the world that we're going to talk about today. And they've saved many people's lives. They've done a lot of different things. So the first person is a doctor. He was the first deaf doctor. His name is Philip Zizov. And he is the first deaf doctor in the United States. The second person that we're going to talk about is Sue Thomas. And she was the first deaf spy for the FBI. Can you imagine how cool is that?
She has skills.
So what she would do is she would lip read, and she was able to help them catch the enemy. Later there was a show that was created in her honor. The third person we're going to talk about today is Andrew J. Foster. And he was the first deaf black man to receive a degree from Gallaudet University. And he also received an honorary degree from Gallaudet for all the work that he did in Africa. Wow, he did some amazing things. So the fourth person we're going to talk about today is the first deaf football player, Derek Coleman. He was drafted for the Seattle Hawks. And he played for the NFL. Wow. So the position he played was defensive safety. The fifth person we're going to talk about today, I'm sure that you already know about the show, Sesame Street. Do you remember Big Bird and Elmo? And the Cookie Monster, all those different characters, that show really inspired all of us. It was the best show ever. We used to watch that when we were younger and growing up, and it was really good. So the lady's name that was on that show is Linda Rowe. And she would teach sign language on the show to all the different children that were on Sesame Street. She did that for many years. She did a lot of work when she was on the show. I wish that the people on the show would still have that on the Sesame Street. So the last person we're going to talk about today, she won an award in 1995 as Miss America, and she was crowned, she won the crown, and she was the first deaf person. Her name is Heather Whitestone. Wow! Miss Alabama. Roll. Hi. Woo. So all six of these people have really inspired us in this world, and they've inspired all the deaf, hard of hearing. I mean, we do many great things in our lives. Anything is possible. So now this is going to conclude the first half of the show. And I hope you've all learned just a little bit about the deaf history today. I know I did. I encourage you to continue to study about the history and learn something that you never knew before. All right, so thank you. So now we're going to take a little quick commercial break. See you later.
Driver's license registration, please. I'm sorry, I don't have it. I've left it at home. I think I left all of my stuff at home. Sorry. Just a moment, sir. Okay, I'm throwing this out. Congratulations! You're one in a million. All over for today. Yes, you win an award. You get two tickets. Okay, this is a big deal. You win two tickets today. It's for the police ball. You won two tickets for the rodeo. You won two tickets for the cat castration. You won two tickets for neuter.
Nah, that's all illegal.
Oh my god! I
failed! Yes!
I'm so excited for my dog, my cats. Can you fix them all, please? Stay neuter, stay neuter.
Congratulations. Here you go. Wait, wait. Wait a second. Your car, the left light is out in the rear.
I'm 12. I don't know how to drive. Okay, my name's Wayne, all right? Oh, I'm just an old man.
It's all right. It's all right. It's okay. It's all right. I understand. I understand everything that's happening with your heart. Stop being ridiculous. Stop it. You obviously need to have a sobriety test.
What is that?
Can I help you with something? I think I'm going to have to definitely give you a sobriety test. I think I'm going to have to give you some more alcohol. I think I'm going to have to, I don't know, I think you could smoke it out.
Do you have any smoke?
I do, actually. How much do you need?
Look, there's a UFO!
There's aliens coming!
Look it up!
Oh, let me shoot it!
Those balls. Please, officer, please. Please do it.
Oh, this is fun just watching.
TJ Story, and today I'm here with my special guest, and my name is Janine Boucher. Today she's going to be teaching the hearing audience a few signs. So I'm going to show you how to introduce yourself to a deaf person. So we're going to learn three signs. How are you? Nice to meet you, and my name, and then you learn to spell your name. So you're gonna have to figure out your ABCs on your own, okay? So we're gonna show you how to do that. How are you? I'm fine. How are you? I'm fine too.
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you too. Your name?
My name, TJ.
TJ, My name is Janine. So that's pretty easy. I hope you all learned something today with our Deaf History Month.
Believe in yourself.
You know, you just need to believe in yourself.
Anything.
That all things are possible. And I'm talking about not just deaf, but part of hearing and hearing as well. So make sure you always follow your dreams.
Don't stop.
Don't let other people think that what you want to do is impossible. Just continue on. Do you all know the man, Martin Luther King Jr., and his words? If you can't fly, then run. And if you can't run, then walk. And if you can't walk,
then crawl.
But what I say, if you can't talk, then sign. ASL, baby.
See you next week.
See you next week.
I want to be the greatest in the world, not for the money and the fame of the girls, not for the donkeys, the guesties, and the vacations in the West Indies, but simply because I love it. When I write, I'm like a puppeteer. Pulling my strings to the melody.
I make them believe.